Tonight, we move an engine. A gangster is born. And a thing gets steamed.
Alright, stop. Get off. Get off.
Right,
get
right, off. Right, right.
I'll
hold it steady.
Max, you're doing nothing. Get the
fuck you.
He's filming.
You're standing on my walkway.
No, I got this. Film. That's more.
Remember that film Wallace and Gromit, that cult documentary thing about that religious cult with the guy and his dog? This is sort of similar to how he did the railway emergency extension process.
So like pizza in general?
Yeah, but worse. In England.
Oh.
In England. Pizza. Yeah. Yeah, no, that's the
they're
one.
Good at everything else.
The English are very good at everything else, better than Americans, except pizza, apparently.
New Haven.
Oh, no, actually, no, that's not right. Because when I was with Keith Appleton, he took me to this unreal pizza place that was like too good to exist. It was like, you know, a real all-around Italian restaurant, but the pizza they made was almost as good as Pepe's.
Oh, shit.
It was scary. And it was in this weird little town that you wouldn't expect to find
pizza
anything good in Keith's own words. Not mine.
I've been addicted to his videos. It's so bad.
Same.
He's a great engineer and fitter, and he's one of the few good model engineers who's accessible.
How the butt fuck are we going to do this?
No, it's okay. It's all right. We'll slowly pizza slice it.
Okay.
Pizza time.
Hey, shut up, cameraman.
No.
Yeah, you're not supposed to talk. Haven't you?
Keep on going. Just keep
swimming. No, Brayden, it's a bad idea.
Just keep swimming.
Brayden, that's a bad idea.
Hey, it fell off once. We could do it again.
That's true, yeah.
It just killed you the first time.
It did. But it's better kill me than kill the engine.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, what?
You're in the gap.
I love life's in the gap. Okay. Wait, is your foot on the wheel?
Yes. Okay. I can't believe how loose that is.
I can't believe we're actually doing this.
I can. I've done much more retarded things than this.
Hey, you can't say the R word on YouTube anymore. Fucking retards.
Someone just beeped at me. I think it's one of our pals behind us. We are currently... You'll have to edit this. Did something bad happen back there? I'm just gonna make sure something. Just give me 2 seconds. Just want to make sure that we didn't have a horrible
thing to happen.
All right. Definitely edit that out. So, we're coming to you live from the Seymour Death Machine, also known as Braden's truck, also known as the Connecticut Kid Mark II Electric Boogaloo, one transmission engine, and every other crucial part of the vehicle later. We are currently transporting a Sirocco high-speed steam engine and a water tube boiler to a shop of mine because I have had enough of setting up temporary caster wheel cart power plant setups connected by steam hoses in the backyard of my house. We are going to make, or at least try to make, a permanent power plant setup in this shop using these two pieces of equipment to start with. The goal eventually is to fill the entire place with steam engines and boilers and dynamos and a switchboard and start making our own electric power for fun and a bunch of other things, but right now this is just the beginning. We've got Brendan, Florian, Max, maybe Phil with us today, and we're going to be having lots of fun. Maybe. Unless the load in back, which is very shoddily tied down with some highly suspect pieces of rope that aren't tied securely, lets go and goes all over the road. Then, briefly, the stationary engine will no longer be a stationary engine. It will be a road locomotive until it encounters another object like a car or a manhole cover, at then which point it will become scrap metal. So that's the agenda today. We also are probably going to steam up a different engine when we get to the shop.
This really being really
Max.
Curious.
Fuck.
My eyes.
Fuck your eyes.
They're primed for removal.
Oh, it's collapsing.
Oh, Max.
No.
No!
Oh, God! Oh, Max!
Oh,
God! You fuck! Oh, you're dressing the other hat?
Okay.
Let's try this again.
Oh my god, Mike without a hat is like a cursed image in my eyes.
Who? Yeah. Alright, Max, this will be on YouTube for forever.
I called you Mike by accident.
Me?
What?
Your other one?
You mean this Florian's hat?
This Florian's hat. They'll go like this.
Yeah, I should not.
Not move at all.
Never. I'm on camera, so I gotta say something silly.
Yeah, we got the boiler and the engine both up here.
For anyone who is misfortunate enough to not know what this is a Showman's road locomotive from England. Not the best built example, but a good runner. Just has something wrong with it. The HP cylinder, for some reason that we are trying to determine, has something like 90% or more blow-by. It might be that the valve isn't seating right, that it's scored up, or that the piston ring is gone, or the combination of the two, because this oiler doesn't feed against steam pressure, and the engine has about 1,000 miles on it. You can tell by all the grit and wear in some of the moving parts that it was used very well, and it was a running engine. But the oiler probably hasn't been working for years, so when the steam arrives at the first cylinder without lubrication, it probably scored the hell out of the valve, probably destroyed the piston ring. When we took the HP cylinder head off, what used to be the graphite ring just was sort of this dry, flaky stuff that came out of the bore. So we definitely have to replace those. I'm not sure if those two things would be the cause of so much violent blow-by. It all goes right to the LP cylinder, but we're going to find out. Even with that problem, this engine runs like crazy, and it was able to pull me up a 14% grade in third gear, which is a bit alarming, actually. It's too powerful for its own good, so...
Watch it have a ring on it.
What, the piston?
Yeah. I doubt it, but
that would be
highly, more confusion.
Highly...
And delay.
Interesting.
Yeah, I said delay.
Engine if I ever
no,
seen
we
one.
Please come out. Yeah, it is. I hate
the M and LMS things
up front. The dynamo bracket, it's got like the golden arches up here. We have the Ronald McDonald fading like
that
on that
the worst
on the McDonald, like on the bunker.
Oh,
right here.
And the fucking,
I hate the
oh,
McDonald.
No.
I hate that it's real.
Oh no,
that like makes me sleep peacefully.
It'll be
like,
the first.
I'm happy about this. I'm happy about the
it'll
McDonald.
Be the first truly Americanized show.
Has Brayden seen it? We're gonna have to.
He has
this.
To have seen it.
Needs
no, he's, no, he hasn't.
It, so.
He hasn't. But
I don't think I've seen
it. Piston rods.
We want to take these pins out so we can disconnect the piston rod from the crosshead.
And then put NyQuil advertisements all over it.
Yes.
Yes.
That's the only reason we're taking anything off is to put NyQuil.
I mean, it's a good lubricant, isn't it?
No, that's the DayQuil side.
Yeah, that's right.
No, the HP is the
Dayquil.
HP's DayQuil.
HP's
DayQuil. LP.
Because LP, yeah, it's lower energy.
Yeah, yeah, lower energy.
Side.
You're kind of trying to die out.
Right. Yours needs to be probably the Frosted Flakes one or, Vagisil. Vagisil. Yeah.
This is the McDonk.
No, it's gonna have.
It already
Vagisil.
Looks like McDonald's
it's already
colors
McDonald's,
anyway.
So just
add some arches.
I hate
do
this.
The golden arches.
I
add
hate
some arches.
Paint just,
no, it looks awful.
Do
add
I
some arches.
It. Whoever is responsible for this needs to be killed.
Put the Hamburglar like dangling.
Dude, put the Hamburglar in
yeah,
the
seat. Yeah, the Hamburglar's
driving. Hey, I moved him.
He has to go in the seat. The
I fucking, I moved him.
And then we'll
I
have
it.
Grimace on the top.
Here, look at that. This is definitely a McDonald's Showman's engine.
I got it in a Happy Meal.
Yeah,
remember,
exactly.
Kids, the M in
oh,
LMS
oh,
stands for McDonald's.
You got it in a Happy Meal.
McGinnis Happy Meal.
The McGinnis,
it's just
the
bologna,
McGinnis meal.
And bologna and bologna no. And some creosote.
Instead of the golden arches, it's the McGinnis logo. Like,
it's like sideways.
McGinnis drive.
Wait, let me find the
end. Welcome to Electric Motor in the Box. May I take your order?
The McHappy Meal.
It's just no. The entire restaurant and drive-thru window is a completely wrecked EP2, and like one of the cooling vents is the drive-thru window.
Oh my god, that sounds awful.
It is. It would be.
This is the piston ring. It's really not that bad. It's not good, but it should not be causing the kind of blow-by that we have.
No, it might be. It might because it also might have shrunk.
I don't think so.
So here's our HP piston. Little guy. About 7/8, maybe 1 inch. It looks smaller than the TT's original plans because that calls for 1 1/8.
I think there's some weird Swiss cheese drilled passage.
I don't think so. No, we tested that. But we're going to test it first with both chest covers off. Because, yeah, the fact that this was getting steam feed from the HP exhaust only when the regulator was open and not shut means that there's nothing wrong with the porting between the cylinders. So it can only be, unless there's something I'm not seeing way back in the bore here. But now that the piston's out, we can look for that, so we better get a light in here.
Yeah, we're gonna need to.
No, I don't feel anything.
We think that this valve is not seating on the face correctly.
Well, so I am almost, that's the only answer.
So we're gonna get some machinist dye and see how far off the face it actually is.
I'm gonna give this piston, a high pressure piston, a new ring because the old one was rotten anyway. Graphite yarn.
It wouldn't have led to that amount of blow by though, I don't think.
It could have, but it's a combination of both.
I think it could be a combination of both.
Let me see what the fish is.
Yeah. So weird.
It's very funny.
Oh, Jesus.
No, it has to,
Here. You can see the scoring on it, where it's been touching and where it hasn't. That indicates that it's not been sitting down all the way, which will leak steam by like crazy.
Yeah, not a good fish.
No, I just mean it all.
Look at that. It's made for it. It's made for it.
Muppet World.
Look. It's a perfect fit. It's perfect. I love it when things work like that.
Speaking of Muppets?
I absolutely love it.
That's a Muppet. Muppeting.
Alright, so it's not quite square, so I'm gonna put some small stuff underneath it as a spring.
God damn it, stop diddly bopping around.
Run it like a real engine.
Stop diddly bopping around. Run it like a real engine.
Run it hard and fast like the real engine.
Take it out on the mains. Take it on the main line.
No.
When I get out on that track, heavy loads, and it works.
Like the prototype.
Is that thin enough?
Yeah, but okay. When you touch it on the face, see what it does here.
I can also do this.
Just a second. No. It has to be on its face. Now, another thing I want to find out is was the valve put in upside down? Because that would fuck things up. Now, let's see what it looks like when it touches the face.
Wait, what are you doing?
I put it on the face. I'm sliding it back and forth, okay? And now we're going to lift it off.
So that is exactly what I did.
Jesus fucking Christ.
Make sure
that is the exact same thing I did.
We're putting out his misery? Oh, hell yeah.
It looks like it's touching down.
Let him suffer. He would be too thrilled.
We need a light.
I have glasses, but not sunglasses.
Give me the regular glasses!
Wait, hold on.
You have sunglasses?
Yeah, I do.
Okay, all right.
Long. All right. Better angle, Newt.
All right, now, give me the pan. The pan from the boat is here. It's over there in that box.
Wait, what?
Give it to me.
The pan from the boat. Go get it.
Florian, it's right over
pan.
There.
It's literally a pan.
It's like a saucepan.
Oh, no. Wait, hold on.
You look like a shitty jazz musician.
It's in a box to your right. It's going to be in one of those boxes. That's fucking it. Give it to me!
Wait, is this the one?
That's the one! Give it to me!
Oh my god, that's like a holy, that's a fucking holy
object! Give me the form and
no, this is a legendary!
Give it to me!
That's a legendary object.
Yes.
Hold on, I'm not ready. Why are you in the picture?
This is funny.
No, get him in there.
Alright, hold on. First, let me get rid of these fucking things.
I don't even know what I'm doing.
Yeah, none of them do. Don't worry.
Yeah, it's okay.
He's like a shitty jazz musician.
Wait, I have to.
Pizza time! Okay.
Pizza
ton. It smells terrible.
Oh, hey! I think...
Did you rearrange any of this?
No, I just took a couple of them.
Is this ours?
Okay, we have to move
They're
the engine to
together
the left.
With brass.
The left.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I saw that yesterday.
Trust me, because when we took it apart and I loosened the bolts on it, they all fell out.
There you go.
Like,
and you'll have to straighten her out when she gets near here, but...
And right before you put it on? Oh, shit, that's going to be tough, dude.
There you go. All right, now my feet might be a problem.
Rich! Rich, because I pried them apart with this.
With a pro ball. Easy fucking
pried. Easy. Did I go too far?
No. No, I just have to... There we go. There!
Yeah, he should just...
That's it. Now I need the rag to seal up the window. There. What did Phil do to you?
Not this Phil, other Phil.
Oh.
You won't be at the bottom of the Schuylkill River.
The Schuylkill River?
Yeah.
Oh, shit. Didn't mean to do that.
Like
put that somewhere safe.
Oh, you imbecile?
No, it's fine. Just put it somewhere safe. I don't want that coming off and getting fucked up. Okay. Scheduling of firing and cylinder head gasket didn't work, and we need to put the cylinder head gasket and cylinder head on because this engine has a very interesting idiosyncrasy, which you can see right now. One of the cylinder head stud holes is ported right into the steam chest that surrounds, well, not the steam chest, but the passage that feeds steam from the boiler to the regulator casing before it goes to the engine. And it's just, right now we're just keeping the fire just barely alive so we can get it immediately up once it starts. Oh, and we burned a hole in the floor card there, which obviously isn't made of metal, which is highly interesting. So that's going to have to be replaced.
That's your fault.
All we're looking for right now, we just did some things to the HP valve and put a new ring on the HP piston. So we're going to see now, what we're looking for is a chup out the LP chest that covers off. If we get a constant stream, we know something's wrong. So we're going to try that right now. We're going to put it in, we're in full gear forward. So we still have a problem. It runs on the HP, but that shouldn't sound like that. That should not friggin' sound like
can
that.
Can I see something?
Put water in the tank because I want to see if we're feeding. Fill it right up to the top.
Oh yeah, it's engaged now.
What is?
I can hear the pump engaging.
Well, I want to see if the check valve is cold. It is! All right, we're gonna up the speed a little. That's more than a little. Fuck you. Wow, well, it's developing significantly more. How's the pressure? We still have the bypass problem. We put a new ring in the HP piston. The valve doesn't look like it's any condition to blow by that much, but there's still about 80% steam blow by, so something very weird is happening there. No evidence of cross-porting. There's no extra holes that go places they shouldn't, so we have a real mystery on our hands.
Oh, that's cool.
occult beast oriented.
What, is anyone going to say it?
No, not crown sheep. It's time to
milk.
You were late.